because we live in a time where people are disconnected from the actual impacts of socialism. Very few people in the United States have ever lived under socialism, and all of them are expatriates from socialist dictatorships, essentially. It's very easy to re-embrace bad ideas because nobody ever sees the price tag. One of the beautiful things about being Bernie Sanders and being a socialist in general in the United States is you get to point to programs in other countries and say, we ought to do that. And then when people ask, how do you pay for that? You go, it'll pay for itself, which is the same thing you hear in timeshare presentations, and it is not true. And whenever somebody says, you know what? Forget about the price tag. It's going to pay for itself. Check your wallet, because I'm sure it is gone. And somebody is already buying stolen VCRs from the back of a truck with it. Okay, that is the way socialism tends to work. Well, it's not just Bernie Sanders embracing this stuff. It is the mayor of New York. So Bill de Blasio tweeted out over the weekend, brothers and sisters, there is plenty of money in this country. There's plenty of money in this world. It's just in the wrong hands. Yes, I would like all the money to be in the hands of a man who has never done anything for his entire life, Bill de Blasio. I also love the brothers and sisters. Kameraden! Comrades! If we are this far from an omelet, all we have to do is break a few eggs. Got to get rid of the kulaks. They have all the money. Once we take the money, it'll be all better. By the way, worth noting, New York City is bankrupt. So that's sad. So his own city is essentially bankrupt at this point, and he's got nothing to say about that, except that he wants to take more money from rich people, which, of course, is not going to work. Okay, the reason, even New Jersey, even New York Governor Andrew Cuomo has says we can't raise taxes on the rich people anymore in this state. They're all leaving and going to Florida. The largest contingent of New Yorkers outside of New York is now living in Florida because everyone is leaving, including, by the way, Alexandra Ocasio-Cortez's mom, who said she moved down to Florida because there was less property tax. But Bill de Blasio is still trying to play this class warfare game where he is pushing for taking away wealth from some and giving the wealth to others. Socialism is all fun and games until it's actually implemented. When it is implemented, like in Venezuela, there's no electricity. Caracas, Venezuela, is now in its fourth day of complete darkness. Refrigeration has failed. People are eating spoiled and rotten food. Socialism, working wherever it's tried. And don't give me Norway and Denmark, guys. Those are capitalist countries with some redistributionist programs stacked on top. If you're talking about socialism, you have to talk like Bill de Blasio, which means nationalization of industry and removal of money from those who make business to those who don't. Well, one of the lead proponents of this nonsense is, of course, Alexandra Ocasio-Cortez, who says the same dumb stuff as Bernie Sanders, but is younger and more attractive and snaps her fingers in a Z formation. And so that means she's cool, I guess. I don't know what that means. In any case, AOC says, if you do not have a job, she's speaking at South by Southwest, and she said, if you don't have a job, you are left to die under capitalism. That's what socialism means, not leaving people to die, which is weird since socialism killed over 100 million people in the last century and is killing a bunch of people in Venezuela right this instant. But apparently under AOC, if you don't have a job under capitalism, you are left to die.
We should not be haunted by the specter of being automated out of work, right? We should be excited by that. But the reason we're not excited by it is because we live in a society where if you don't have a job, you are left to die. And that is at its core our problem.
Oh, that's a problem. Oh, you're right. She's the first person ever to discover that leaving people to die is bad, which is weird since, again, socialism routinely leaves people to die so long as those people get in the way of the grand socialist vision. Mass exterminations under socialism have not been rare, it turns out. Dissidents are still in jail in Cuba. People in Venezuela, as I mentioned, starving to death. China eradicated some 40 million of its own citizens. The Soviet Union routinely gulagged political opponents and also killed a bunch of people in the Ukraine in the 1930s. So socialism basically has been a party. The notion that socialism is just wonderful for human lives, that they are seeking to preserve every human life, and that if you don't have a job, you're left to die under capitalism, it's just absurd.